Hello and welcome to God's Minute. I'm Pastor Jonathan Conrad, and I am the senior pastor at St. Paul's Lutheran Church in Wilmington, North Carolina. This week, we are looking at the five words of Philemon. These are five words that I want to focus on as we look at this letter that was written by Paul. It's a very important letter and one that is very popular among Christians and theologians and people who study the Bible. So let's get right to it today by going to the first section of the letter, which is our first reading for today. Paul, a prisoner of Christ Jesus, and Timothy, our brother, to Philemon, our dear friend and co-worker, to Apphia, our sister, to Archippus, our fellow soldier, and to the church in your house. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. The first word for the week is house. Back in early Christianity, there was no such thing as a church building like we are used to now. Early Christians would meet in people's houses. So that's where you get the idea of the house church, which is still a popular idea and project of today. And in these houses, people would gather to read and hear the story of Jesus. But they would also gather to hear letters that have been sent to them from apostles, such as Paul. So, this is a letter sent by Paul the apostle to Philemon, and Philemon has his friends gathered together, most likely in Philemon's house. So, this is not a personal letter just to Philemon, it is to Philemon and all those who gather with him. Now, the reason I want to concentrate on house is because during this time of a pandemic, it is very important for us to continue this house worship. Now, it's going to look a little bit different for each and every one of us. Now, some of us have a family. Some of us may live alone. But no matter what your situation is, you can continue to worship God in your house. And I wanted to give you a couple of steps on how you can do that each and every day so that you and God can strengthen your relationship with one another. And what I am going to do is I'm going to call these the house rules, and they are four parts. And I've used four parts of the St. Paul mission statement to get my point across. So I hope you enjoy it and that it is useful to you. The first one is welcome. Welcome God into your house and heart. The best way to do this is through prayer. So the first thing you can do is say the Lord's Prayer, or come up with your own prayer, but something that you can use day in and day out as a way to prepare and start your time with God. And then proclaim the good news, which is through your actions. How are you treating your neighbor? How are you treating those who are in the same house with you? And are you also worshiping God with your family or with your friends or whoever you find yourself with during this time of a pandemic? Experience God by reading your Bible daily. This is very important. You have to continue to read God's Word. We have to continue to open the Bible and let God's Word speak to us. Finally, we have share. Share your love of God to God. What I mean by this is that it's nice to tell others that you love God, but I think it's important that you tell God how much you love God. Share your love of God to God. And you can do this by journaling, keeping a diary, and making it a love letter, if you will, to God, and do this on a daily basis. Another way you can do it is through drawing. So if you are a better artist, or you're just wanting to do something from an artistic standpoint, draw a picture every day that describes God to you. Also, there is singing. Sing songs to God, or find a song or find an artist that you like that could be part of your daily routine when it comes to this house rules type of church. One of the suggestions I want to give you is my colleague, Pastor Mark Opgrand, in the daily In Your Home devotion that he does, he gives you several options of songs you can catch on YouTube, and they're all great selections dealing on the theme of the day for Pastor Mark. So you can catch those on our Facebook page at St. Paul's Lutheran Church. But I think that you can find a lot of strength and see that your relationship with God will become stronger if you go by the house rules. Because it's very important that we continue to worship God each and every day in our house, because really we want to make this house God's house as well. Thank you for joining me today. I will see you tomorrow for another edition of God's Minute. You take care and God bless.